pull off Coby Gewertz's idea for his 34 coupe was Bill Ganahl. Their creation, St. Christopher, is making hot rodding hot again. This thing is so cool. What's up, man? When we saw this car at the Grand National Roadster Show, it had just been debuted with this beautiful paint job. This is stunning.
Thanks. Yeah, it made a lot of waves at the show.
And you brought barf bags when you debuted it.
Yeah, we knew it was going to be a little bit controversial, so we wanted to prepare for people who might have an adverse reaction to it, so we brought barf bags.
The workmanship on this car is unreal. You guys just won Hot Rod of the Year.
Yeah.
That's massive.
It was a surprise. We weren't sure, you know, with how ostentatious the car is, you never know, you know, if that's what they're looking for. It's got to look good on a t-shirt the next year and all that kind of stuff, but they really liked the car. We had a lot of fun competing for that award. The top five cars were all phenomenal. We just feel really blessed, you know, to have been chosen. There's nothing machine made on this car. Everything's made by hand. So that's part of the tradition that we're trying to sort of bring back and have people recognize where hot rodding's roots are coming from. And I feel that that's important, and I probably more so because our parents were in that era. They're the ones who made it possible for us to be doing what we're doing now.
So this is a good segue to talk about your dad.
Yep.
Your dad, too tall, Pat Ganahl, right? And you lost him recently.
Yep. He was the editor, managing editor for Street Rodder when he started. He was the editor of Hot Rod magazine, and then he brought back Rod and Custom magazine. The last magazine he worked for was the Rodder's Journal.
So he did get to see the car, but he didn't get to see the
paint.
He
didn't get to see this car done, and that's, yeah, I mean, obviously there's nothing good about him passing, but many regrets, not being able to see this done is a big one.
I suspect he's probably seen it. Dude, dads never leave.
Yeah, yeah.
They are always around, especially if they're hot rodders.
Yeah, yeah.
When we start looking around at cars that we want to feature, mm-hmm. there's a lot. But this one stood out. It is...
I don't know why.
I don't even know when, you know, what color do you tell people it is?
It's colors. It's the rainbow, yeah. So...
use House of Colors?
Most of the paint on this car is House of Color. Yeah. Joe Campani and Ryan Campy did most of the body work and paint. But it was really a group effort. Coby had the idea for doing the stripes from the very get-go, and that never changed. The color palette, how the stripes were laid out, the gold leaf, all of that went through different iterations and ideas. So it was a long process to come up with what actually ended up on the car. People who don't know what the inspiration for the paint scheme came from just think we're crazy. You know, who would do this to a car? This has never been done before. But it really comes from the tradition of late 60s, early 70s drag racing when they were doing psychedelic paint jobs. And the paint jobs weren't meant to be pretty per se. They were meant to be noticed. They wanted to be fast, they wanted to win, but they also wanted to be remembered. So Coby grew up around that, and this is what he grew up with, this type of paint job on a dragster. Our idea, his idea, was just to put that type of paint job on a car that had never been put on before. So the idea of this paint job on a 34 body is what's unique, mm-hmm. and why some people love it and some people hate it. Some people are really pissed off that we did this to this car.
Gold leaf.
Gold leaf.
That's not paint in there.
No, that's real gold.
And did you watch,
Yeah, so.
Did you watch it go down?
It comes in little sheets, basically. Mm-hmm. And Eric Reyes did the gold leaf and all the striping on the car. I think we actually measured out how many feet it was. I think it was like 70 feet or something like that.
Wow.
So these little swirls you see?
Yes.
So every single one of those swirls is hand turned. So you take a little, it's like a stick with a little like felt thing
after
on it.
After it's laid down. So it looks kind of boring, and then he's putting that little design in.
So every single strip is put on, wow. and then every single one of those little turns you see is hand done. The process of painting this car because it has all the colors in the rainbow on it, mm-hmm. was really intense. What you don't want is when you put another color over a second mm-hmm. color, it can bleed out or do funny things. So once you clear it, it really protects the paint and won't allow the other color to leach or do anything. Yeah. So Eric came in, laid down the leaf, mm-hmm. did the striping, and then cleared over all that. So what you're feeling is just barely the stripe is raised just a little bit, but then it's cleared over that and then cut and rubbed again.
I mean, your eye doesn't see any of it. It looks really good.
Yeah.
How were you imagining the spacing where it was going to hit the stacks, and then the design on the roof and what the overhead view? There's a lot to this.
We decided finally that the stripes had to be angled way back so that the car looked like it was going 100 miles an hour standing still. We had to contend with the louvers. Mm-hmm. We had to contend with, you know, where the stripes are going to fall on the car. And this car is such a crazy shape that to get a straight line to look right on it is just, I mean, it was very difficult. So when we first started looking at the stripes, I actually got lasers out. And
you can then find where it hits this curve.
Where it lays over the curves. So we did the initial thing with the laser, and then basically turned it over to Eric and just said, we want it to look not like it was done with a laser, but like it was done by hand.
It looks like if it was like dipped in something mm-hmm. and it would have fallen into that.
Yeah, yeah, it's like an Easter egg. Kind of.
Yes, that's what it looked. Yes, it's an Easter egg. Yeah. That's it, that's all it is. Yep. So this car is St. Christopher, and there's a story behind it. Coby operates Church Equipped. That's how he's known.
Yep. Yeah,
tell me about that.
Yeah, so Church, it's really Church, or the name came from him going drag racing as a kid. It would always be on Sunday.
On Sunday. He spent his Sundays
That's
hot rodding.
Was Church for him. St. Christopher is the patron saint of travel. It has the whole church, you know, religious connotation to it.
There are so many things I want to talk about and look at, but honestly, like, look at this grill.
It's the focal point of the car in a way.
So that's a 34 grill.
Yep.
You have components from 33. So you're kind of calling it a 34 Ford Coupe.
We call it a 34 because the grill is really the, it's a 34 Ford grill, which is iconic in itself and differentiates from the 33 grill. The body is a 33 body, but there's a few details if you know what you're looking at.
And there's no radiator.
There's no radiator.
No radiator.
I was the one who suggested we put it in the back, completely out of the picture. Actually, on this car, it was one of the things I was the most nervous about because I've never used a remote radiator before. It took a lot of work to get the water all to flow right and to bleed properly. That's what you're concerned about. You don't want any air pockets in the hoses. Mm-hmm.
That's a 331 Hemi.
It's a 331, yeah. So that's
painted the block to match.
It's matched to this stripe.
You touched the car.
I'm allowed.
Gosh. It's painted to match that color, that orangish.
Yeah,
color.
Yeah, because that was the stripe it's kind of closest to, so we wanted that to match, yeah.
How much horsepower does this make?
We didn't dyno it before we put it in the car, so I couldn't tell you exactly how much horsepower it makes. I can tell you that it is fast and loud, and it's really fun to drive, yeah. Bob McRae did the heads for us, and we put adjustable rockers on it. It's got a cam in it, but it's, you know, bored 30 over. It's not, you know, bored or stroked per se. Okay. It's you know, about a 331. Mm-hmm. The setback motor, you know, that's part of the race look, you know, your weight distribution. Everything about the car is made to look like this thing is just a race car.
How far back did you push it where the original would have sat?
I really dictated it by where the stacks were going to come through the firewall. I didn't want them to be too far back. And Coby also wanting to drive the car.
Yeah.
You
can still see through all of those? They're not too much?
Kinda.
Kinda.
Just enough.
Okay.
Wait till you drive it. It's plenty of power.
Okay.
It's pretty fun. If you take it easy, like this, I drive this car to New York. It's super easy to drive. We put the T5 five-speed transmission with an overdrive in it.
Okay.
The rear end gears 411s with the overdrive.
Yeah.
It's pretty tame. The engine itself, the goal was to make it look like it is mechanical fuel injection.
Right, but you've got a Holley EFI in this thing.
Yes.
So it's fully modern.
All the mechanical components of the fuel injection are all dummied. They're all made to look exactly like they would actually function, but none of them actually work. All of the electronic components are either hidden disguised so that most people who would walk up on this, even some hot rodders, would come up and ask if we ran the mechanical injection on it. And those mechanical fuel injections were basically designed for wide open throttle. They weren't drivable on the street. Some people right. have done it, but it's not great.
So the EFI gives you a more predictable in different power ranges.
Completely tunable, mm-hmm. all the drivability.
Really cool that you can see your steering right here.
The steering column's super long because obviously everything's pushed back. Mm-hmm. It's all mechanical, you know, obviously there's no power steering in something mm-hmm. like this. The front tires are so small that this thing, I mean, it steers really easily just as is. And the tires are, I think, 125s. They're really small. Yeah. The zoomies are ceramic coated, so they're okay. they're painted to withstand the obviously the really high temperatures.
The heat. Mm-hmm.
And then we matched kind of something that
it's
would
like
look
an like an anthracite color or something. It's a really, it's not black, it's a really
right.
cool color.
They are real magnesium wheels.
Oh. But you protecting the
surface. We actually painted them. A lot of people ask me whether this is real magnesium or
yeah.
not. The fronts are spindle mounts. The bearings are actually in the wheel.
Mm-hmm.
And then there's a nut that just holds the wheel right onto the spindle. And they were simple. They were light. They were, you know, you didn't have extra parts to add weight. So the big problem for us was, again, we wanted the car to be functional. So we wanted to put front brakes on it. There's a rotor that mounts to the back of the wheel. And then a bracket that comes off of the spindle that holds the caliper,
okay.
which everything works great, but if you ever want to take the wheel off.
You have to take all the brakes off too?
Yeah, it's a real pain in the butt.
Yeah.
These are big window Hallebrand wheels, sprints are what they mm-hmm. were originally called, but they were very common on dragsters. These are 1610s.
Is it normal that they would have had like these blocks on the side?
So that is the iconic pie crust.
Mm.
So you would say pie crust slicks if they have the pie
okay.
crust on them.
They look so aggressive.
We had to fit this thing under a 34 fender and keep it as low as we possibly could. So we actually widened the fenders by just a little bit.
Okay. Oh my gosh. And then, hold on, this is not graceful. And I can just,
yep.
okay.
That's it.
That was not too aggressive. All the haters out there.
Yeah.
Of 85 splines, I have to find the right one.
Yep. You have to pass the test before you can drive the car.
Let's go to intermission.
Oh yeah.
Yay.
Woo! Can you reach the pedals?
Yes.
You're good?
I can completely reach the pedals.
Yeah, yeah.
Oh, I can see the light coming in.
Yep.
This red Lexan. Is that Lexan or
it's
glass?
Lexan. Yep.
Lexan.
Yep.
And when we go out in the sun, this is going to cast through those louvers.
Yeah, so it actually, when the sun hits it, it almost looks like a prism in here. Like it, because it
wow.
goes through the louvers and it looks like a electric light show.
When you chopped all of this, all of these windows, windshield had to be made custom.
So chopping the top on a car is way more work than most people think of when you just think, all right, you're going to cut the roof and lay it down. That's the easy part,
mm-hmm.
making all of the garnish right. moldings and all the window, you know, mechanisms, the felts, all that stuff actually
and
fit.
You handmade all of these pieces?
Or well, there it's the original garnish moldings, but you have to
sure.
chop everything
sure.
to fit. Yeah.
Oh, this is that medallion
yep.
you were talking about.
That's the.
Is it like a coin?
So Lucky Burton makes them, and
they're
and
already embedded in this.
Glues
knob.
Them onto the knob. Yeah. So
wow. Okay. So what we're sitting on are desk seats.
Yeah, does it make it feel make you
covered.
Feel like you're back in school?
No, I feel way more cool.
Really?
Way cooler than that. This is so cool, and this like quilted northern.
So
is beautiful.
The interior, the pattern in here, the
mm-hmm.
this is called
mm-hmm.
you know tuck and roll pleats.
Okay.
And again, Chris Plant did all of the interior.
Is that all done with stitching?
It's all stitched. Tuck and roll is backstitch, so you don't see the seam. Mm-hmm. But it's tufted like this,
yes,
and this is pleated where you do see the
So
seam.
All of these panels had to be thought out where all of the stitching would align perfectly
and,
by the time you installed these different panels.
And he made it all in one piece.
This is insane.
Yeah. We've got all the correct instrumentation here, which we put in just because this is, you know, a street car. We wanted to monitor the vitals.
Your stacks are not really in the way. I'm surprised
no.
I can actually see. I was expecting this to be too low for my height, but I don't feel too bad.
Yeah, no, it's choppy.
Do we get it fired up? Can we fire it up in here?
You want to fire it up?
Oh it's premium?
Run it on 91.
Oh.
Yeah, it's premium, but
yeah.
So when you fire it up, the injectors leak down a little bit, so it allows a little bit of fuel, and so when you fire it up, that's what that puff is.
Smoke and smell.
Yep. Yeah, it's a monster.
Before we drive this, I want to put it up on that lift. Is that possible?
Yeah.
Can you pull that car down and
of course
look underneath it?
Yeah.
I'll be rad. This is gorgeous under here. You've got so much chrome, your frame and your drive shaft, everything is painted this beautiful chocolate color. I don't know, what is that color?
Root beer brown.
Root beer brown.
Yep.
Tell me about the underneath here. It's just stunning.
Yeah,
it's
well, clean. So we try to make the undersides, you know, look just as good as the stuff you can see. Mm-hmm. And that's exactly it. We got a bunch of chrome. I mean, hot rods were all about having a lot of chrome. Mm-hmm. We want it to work good, look good, you know, all the above. So we figure out what parts we're going to chrome, what parts we're going to paint. So our painter, he jigs up all these parts and paints them body color, all automotive paint, cuts and rubs a lot of this stuff. The whole chassis is all sanded and polished.
Tell me about your suspension.
So the suspension is basically early Ford derived. The front here, it's got a tube axle, dropped axle, which lowers the car. The radius rods here are from a 46 to 48 Ford. These originally went the other way around, so they'd have this dog leg here, mm-hmm. and it would
hanging
go lower.
Down, but it'd hit, come in and hit your zoomies.
So my idea was to flip them over so that they would clear the headers exactly.
Yep. Unbelievable how every little piece has been thought out. It's gorgeous.
We go so far as, you know, even the hardware. So, mm-hmm. you know, like you pick a theme on this car, and so button head Allens, you know, button heads were very race inspired. Mm-hmm. Aircraft dictated a lot of what the early hot rodders were using because they'd go to aircraft surplus stores and get gauges, get, you know, certain parts.
Yeah.
And hardware, some of that is aircraft derived. You can really see the headers here. Mm-hmm. So, you know, all this tubing is cut and weld it basically and mm-hmm. splice it. Getting this all to really line up properly is an art, I guess.
Sure.
It's the fun part of it. The T5 transmission, it's a pretty dainty kind of, you know, small transmission, which is good.
Yeah, you can, it's not very,
you know,
big
for a small car. So I was talking about the cooling system.
Yeah, what is
so
that called?
These four hoses here.
All of this big giant.
Yeah, that's all collector. The cooling system. So that's how the water's conveyed from the front to the rear.
And that's specifically because you put the radiator back there.
Exactly.
So there's no airflow though.
No, there's airflow coming underneath the car. Granted, it's, you know, a little bit warmed up from the headers, but mm-hmm. there's no exhaust on this thing. So by the time it gets back there, it's actually pretty cool.
That's true.
Then plus the fan. Mm-hmm. And then also these aluminum tubes here, because they're aluminum, they actually dissipate heat themselves.
Right.
So it's added.
So cooling. Is this some sort of a known method, or did you have to invent the wheel?
Oh, I was just flying by the seat of my pants, honestly. I've never done one before. Mm-hmm. Ron Davis Radiators made the radiator for me, and he's a guy who you can call up and talk to him. I said, you know, what diameter tubing based on this configuration is good, and he's like, inch and a half will be perfect. Use aluminum.
Not touching my white pants.
Yeah.
This is a stunning car. All right, look, I'm wiping it off on you. Let me go drive this thing. Let's go out and drive it.
All right, let's drive it.
All right. Oh. All right, Bill. The burnout king, baby.
You ready?
Yes. Do it. That this is a mile from my arms.
I built it for my arms.
Yeah, but not for your head. That my great thing is I can see.
Yeah.
Oh my gosh. Okay.
All right.
You're in gear, right?
Strap in.
Strap in. I can't even reach.
Yep.
Works a little bit. Wow, this clutch side, it has a stick to it.
It lets out high too.
Man, okay, it's letting out high. Hold on. What the hell, man? It's not going anywhere.
Keep going. Okay.
Keep going.
here.
Red lines at.
when your ears start stinging,
right,
that's your red light.
See why it won, and you are the man. And I now know why Coby trusted you. Thank you, Coby, for letting me drive this for you. Being willing to sit passenger is awesome.
I managed.
You didn't die.
I thought I would be a little more scared than I was, but you did really well.
All right.
Yeah.
Very cool. Well, you guys know what to do. This is Bill Ganahl, South City Rod and Custom, and we'll catch you guys next time. If you want to support us, go to patreon.com/NicoleJohnsonsDetour or check out our awesome merchandise at NicoleJohnsonsDetour.com.
To make it look this simple takes a ton of work. Mm-hmm. Am I allowed to cuss on this one?
No.
Shoot.
Don't ask. Why don't you just like lean a little bit? Hold on. Hey, Bill.
I was a little nervous about it. Need to use the bathroom again?
Listen.
Is that your fingers?
Yeah. Oh. Ready? This is a hot rod. Let's do that again. Do you know vacuum?
No.
Watch this.